The incubator temperature regulator. Welcome to today's tutorial. We will learn about analog measurements, how to measure raw analog values, convert and scale it to the required unit of measurement, display it on a 7-segment display, and adjust the temperature set point. The push button switches, LEDs, buzzers, and the 7-segment displays are all digital input-output devices, since they are either on or off. Analog signals vary continuously between the off, which is 0 volts, and the on, which is 5 volts. Analog signals such as voltage, pressure, and temperature must first be converted to digital signals before the microcontroller can process it. Microcontrollers like the PIC16F628A and the Arduino Nano board comes with inbuilt 10-bit analog-to-digital converters. The Arduino Nano has 8 analog-to-digital converters from pin A0 to A7 with a default internal reference voltage of 5 volts. The AREF pin is used for reference voltage apart from the 5 volts. The analog-to-digital converter converts 0 volts to 10 zeros and 5 volts to 10 ones, corresponding to 0x03FF hexadecimal and 1023 decimal values. Other voltage values between the 0 volts and the 5 volts are converted to digital values between the 10 zeros and the 10 ones. LD Micro uses the AD converter read instruction element, which can be inserted directly from the instruction menu. In simulation mode, double-click on the variable name in the lower window to display a slider bar. Hold down the left button of your mouse on the bar and drag it down. Observe that the variable value increases from 0 to 1023. Exit the simulation mode and insert 4 coils in parallel in a lower room. Insert compare for greater than in line with each coil and assign the AD converter read variable name as their close if value, and their greater values as 200, 400, 600, and 800. Simulate the program and observe that as the slider bar is adjusted downward, each coil is activated when the condition values match the analog value. Set up the circuit diagram as shown, with a single 4-digit 7-segment display, or 2 pieces of 2-digit 7-segment display, a 10 kilo ohms resistor, 2 push-button switches, and a LED. Open a new program window. Insert the instruction element as shown, with 2000 milliseconds for the turn-on delay timer, and 2 milliseconds for the turn-off delay timer. Insert div 16-bit integer divide and mode integer divide remainder from the signed variables operations option of the instruction menu. An integer divide by 1000 is first performed on the variable value of the AD converter read to extract the 1000 digits to be shown on the 7-segment display. The mode instruction on the variable extracts the remainder of the integer division. An integer division by 100 is then performed on the remainder to extract the 100 digits. This operation is carried on until the unit digit is gotten. Replicate the rungs from the last sections of the car parking counter in tutorial 9 as shown. Since the program is for a 4-digit 7-segment display, change the maximum value of the circular counter to 3. Also, add a rung that will trigger the display of the 4th digit. After compiling the logic in LD Micro, the generated ladder.h file contains another line of code at the end that says #includes_adclib.h. In previous tutorials, we always commented out the #includes_uselib.h line without any compiler error. At this stage, these files should be copied from the LD Micro program folder and placed in the same folder of your code files. Regards to Rare Greeter for his comment on this. Then, upload the code into the Arduino Nano and observe that as the potentiometer is adjusted, the value on the display changes. Zero is displayed at one end of the potentiometer, while 1023 is displayed at the other end of 5 volts. This digital representation requires scaling to the actual measured voltage for display. The measured voltage can be derived by this simple integer math equation. In this case, the reference voltage is 5 volts. Then, to display the value after the decimal point, the remainder value from the actual voltage equation is calculated with the mode instruction element. Now, let's modify the previous LD micro program. Delete this instruction element. Insert these instructions after the AD converter read instruction. Change the source of these four move instructions as shown. Observe that the source digit 4 is V, which is the unit of measurement of voltage. Add a negated coil below Y digit 1 com, named Y dot. Then compile and upload the code into the Arduino Nano board. Observe the display of the actual voltage measured with decimal point and unit of measurement. To measure voltage above 5 volts, a voltage divider circuit is required. For a voltage range of 0 to 30 volts, resistors of the following configuration and values are required. In LD micro, multiplying the previous displayed scaled values with 6 will produce the actual measured voltage reading. See the microcontroller interfacing page of LD micro for more details on this calculation. Finally, let us create the incubator temperature regulator. First, replace the potentiometer in the previous circuit diagram with the LM35 temperature sensor as shown. The LM35 sensor measures temperature in centigrade and produces a voltage output of 10 mV per centigrade. It can measure temperature ranging from 2 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius. See data sheet in the link below. To scale the temperature measurement, use this simplified math equation derived from the 10 mV per centigrade expression. First, multiply the actual voltage with 22 before dividing by 45. The temperature value is converted here and moved to the display here. A circular counter named CMenu, triggered by a push button switch, cycles through 3 menu options. When CMenu is 0, the default menu is displayed showing the temperature reading, and C, the unit of temperature measurement. The second menu option is where the lower temperature set point can be set with the X up or X down push button switches. The higher set point can be adjusted when the CMenu is 2. The make persistent instruction from the instruction menu is used to store the lower and the higher set points to the EEPROM. The set points are automatically restored whenever the incubator is turned off and turned back on. The rung here ensures the incubator temperature is between the higher and the lower set points. It turns on the heater when the temperature goes below the lower set points and turns it off when it goes above the higher set points. The instruction digit not equal to 0 is placed here to blank out the first digit when the temperature reading is below 100 degrees Celsius. Ensure that you change the file name of roomlib.h to lowercase to match the code line in the ladder.h file and prevent compiler error in Arduino IDE. When this program is tested on the breadboard circuit, observe that the current room temperature is being displayed on the 7-segment display. Press the menu button once to adjust the lower temperature set point, and press again to adjust the higher temperature set point. The red LED is used to represent the function of the heater. When the temperature is below the lower set point, the LED comes on. It goes off when the temperature rises above the higher set point. The circuit diagram shown here with a transistor and a relay should replace the LED for practical application. The next tutorial video will show how you can set up your own low-cost serial liquid crystal display with PIC16F628A microcontroller. Interface it with the Arduino Nano and program it with LD Micro. You must have enjoyed this tutorial. Please don't leave without clicking on the subscribe button. Like the video and leave a comment below. See you in the next tutorial.